Hey there, everybody. Jim Douglas here in the sanctuary here at St. Margaret's on this lovely early spring day. I hope all is well with you and yours. As we continue to kind of navigate these strange times of no school and working from home and non-essential businesses being closed, I know that we're all kind of searching for sources of comfort. And for me, I know they're found in, probably for many of you, they're found in things like scripture, daily devotions, prayer, reading and writing, maybe even a little Netflix and Hulu. I know in our house, we're finding comfort in the wonders of Disney Plus. So that's been a wonderful addition. But at any rate, personally, again, for me, in times like this, I often find comfort and hope in church music and sacred music. Specifically, in particular, the Anglican choral tradition that our Episcopal Church has, and the wonderful hymns that we have inherited over time, the great ones that have withstood the test of time, going back decades and centuries. What I wanted to do was share with you a couple online resources so that you at home, if you'd like to add a hymn of the day or a devotion to read through a hymn text, that you can do so, whether from your phone or your computer or laptop or anywhere you can get internet. The first resource is a website called hymnary.org, hymnary.org. This website is a wonderful resource. I'm on it every week. I think a week doesn't go by where I'm not on there looking at something or using something or reading something. On there you can find hymns and hymnals of all denominations, hymn texts, hymn tunes, PDFs, images of different hymnals, including our own 82 hymnal. I highly recommend perusing that. You can spend a lot of time looking at different things on there. It's great. The second website is Public Domain Hymns, pdhymns.org, pdhymns.org. Similar to hymnary.org, you can find a ton of hymns, and they're categorized and organized in a little different way. You can find hymns that are for children, hymns that are paraphrases on scripture and on the Psalms, which I'll talk about in a moment. Also, you can find pages with Christmas carols, Easter carols, and a whole lot more. So with offering those resources, and with that said, in the coming days and weeks with the videos that I will be offering the parish and the wider community, I hope to share my own personal favorite hymns with you that are also really appropriate and worth, you know, giving thought and to and pondering in these crazy times that we're kind of living in right now. So I hope to be able to share some of my favorites with you, and then I'll have members of the band do the same thing, and choir members as well, adult choristers and youth choristers. It's my hope that you all will do the same and share your favorite hymns with me and with Peter and Patty and the staff, so that way we can create a master list and on some of these videos play through them, kind of do a total request live, but a hymnal version, if you will. With that said, today's first hymn, sort of meditation, if you will, daily devotion on the hymn, O God, Our Help in Ages Past, which in our 1982 hymnal is hymn number 680. It's a well-known hymn. I'm sure many of us probably know the first verse by heart. O God, Our Help in Ages Past, Our Hope for Years to Come, Our Shelter Through the Stormy Blast, and Our Eternal Home. This hymn comes from the 1600s by the prolific English hymn writer Isaac Watts, who has over 700, I think close to 750 hymns to his credit, many of which are in our hymnal. This is probably one of his most well-known ones that is particularly appropriate to think about and to read through and to sing through during these times. So what I'll do is I will read a verse, I'll read a couple verses maybe, and then play through a couple verses, and feel free to sing from home if you sing along from home if you'd like. O God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, our shelter from the stormy blast and our eternal home. Under the shadow of thy throne, thy saints have dwelt secure. Sufficient is thine arm alone, and our defense is sure. Psalter, Psalm 90. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from one generation to another. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from one generation to another. So until next time, until our next video, be well, all of you, and send in your favorite hymns. Take care.